Well, not just the season, but beyond too. They want to do it on a regular basis. I mean, they've done a great job watering, fertilizing. They put in a new water line for our, you know, for game time. We can just tap right from here. We don't have to make jugs.
This is like just information. It's just knowledge, right? And somebody had to step up and say, hey, we can help you guys. Yeah. It didn't take millions of dollars or
just
approval from DOE or whatever.
It's just community people wanting to give back to the school. I mean, one person, Dr. Wall, has been doing it for years. He does the watering. He's still involved. But we're lucky that DOU is sending some of their workers and HRI. So they're just a big help for us.
The field feels soft. Even the patches are soft. Yeah. They're not hard like they used to be.
So it's something new for us. Today's the first day we're going to be on it.
Oh, yeah?
We haven't been on it since.
And then you guys will still, during the season, practice up here.
Oh, certainly, because, I mean, they're going to start softball, community soccer, so it's going to be crowded up there. We won't have room, so we're going to need to practice here, but we're going to, you know, minimize the amount of time we're on.
Dwight, the groundskeeper guy said, cleats are good for the grass because it aerates. Yeah. I didn't know that.
Yeah, soft as the ground, yeah.
Okay. And I come up here to the school and volunteer to help on the field, get it in condition.
You've been around here for years. This is probably as nice as I've seen it, as far as where you could grow something. It's covered. The good stuff is covering a good, I would say, 95% of the field, or higher actually. So the middle area is just impossible, because even though it's soft, there's no drainage here. This is a flood zone.
Yeah, this is the flood zone. This
track season, there'll be like a moat right around the field on the track.
When we get a heavy rain, this is all flooded out, all water. And really,
it doesn't have anywhere
drainage.
To go. Yeah.
No, nowhere to go. This is it right here.
Yeah.
We're going to be keeping an eye on it as they're practicing, and we're going to be watering the grass after their practices to keep it healthy and everything. And we'll fertilize it a couple more times to keep it really nice looking there.
You know what kind of grass this is?
This is a mixture of everything. It's just not one type of grass. It's all.
So 2 years ago, when they tried to really, you know, make it a point to fix this up, 2-3 years ago, they were planting this stuff, or was it something different?
As far as I know, this grass has been here since whenever.
So it's the same stuff.
It's the same stuff.
It's just been cared for now.
Yeah.
Okay.
And as you can see, some of the grass, the clumpy grass, is disappearing. It's becoming more one type of grass now.
Yeah. How does that work?
Well, just keeping it cut short and everything, watering it.
How do you get rid of the bad grass?
Well, just like I say, keep growing. We're cutting it at an inch and a half. And if you don't let it grow high where it seeds, then eventually
it'll bolt, and then the seeds just fall. Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I thought only vegetables and flowers bolted.
No, the grass does too.
That makes sense. Okay, so if you had maybe like 6 months, you could get rid of these patches, right?
All these patches.
Bald spots, yeah.
Oh, next season you probably won't even see those. Next season.
But if this was a golf course, you could turn this into like bunkers.
Yeah.
Right? A couple of bunkers.
This would be a bunker here.
But the quality of this grass right now, I'm walking on, is soft. It's not golf course soft. That's Bermuda that is meticulously. Here's Ryan. He's a Dolphins fan.
Miami Dolphins fan, yeah. All right.
You notice he doesn't wear Dolphin stuff anymore. I don't know why.
Because I only have one t-shirt and it's dirty. Otherwise, I'd wear it every day.
No, you wouldn't. Yeah. We're talking about the grass. This is the nicest I've seen it for a few years.
It's the nicest I've seen it in my lifespan.
Yeah. So it's this guy is responsible.
Really? What's your name, sir?
Dwight.
Congratulations, it looks wonderful. The first thing I said to myself when I got here today was, I must be at the wrong school. And the second thing I said to myself is, they hired Mr. Green Jeans, and apparently they have.
Yeah.
No, that's what they said, that this is the best that's looked for a long time.
Well, good. Congratulations.
But I was telling you, a couple years ago, they had some of this roped off over here.
Right.
They're really trying. And then, but once the season started, they just...
I've seen a lake over here before.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes it's a motor on this field. When it rains heavy.
Oh, great. Okay. You've done great. Thank you very much.
Well, good. I hope you keep going. I know you're volunteering. They're not paying you to do this, so.
I'm going to be here as long as they want me to come and work on the field.
Great. right, man. Nice meeting you, man.
Nice meeting you.
I got my red dress on tonight, dancing in the dark in the pale moonlight. Throw my hair up real big.